So we're going to Nashville, guys. Nothing new. We're going to Opryland, guys. Nothing new. There's one thing that is new. We're staying in Opryland. Woo! Babe's almost ready.
Yeah, my hair's not cut.
Look at that.
Purchase your tracks today.
Rough and bad. But Babe's hair is all. What's the look you got? Not makeup, but makeup?
No makeup, makeup look.
No makeup, makeup look. That's, I told her that's like the equivalent is me saying, I don't have rims, I have wheels.
Nobody stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought it would die. But ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb. But the enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long. Cause he gon' step in and make it alright.
We're currently trying to pack the car, and this guy is gonna help me pack.
And we're leaving. Yeah. It's official, it's official, it's official.
Purchase your tracks today.
All right, so I just checked in.
Come on, JJ.
Come on, buddy. Put on the hand. Oh, you got it all by yourself, huh?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, JJ. You got you in your own room.
We have arrived at the Gaylord Opryland Hotel.
Here, this is our king-size bed with a random pillow that reminds us of what?
What does this remind you of? Something that needs to be cleaned. You caught that on video, huh? Oh, it's not bad. It's not that bad. You just
there
walk
you
away.
Go.
Look
good
how comfortable that was.
Good job.
You gotta put your arm back in there, huh?
What the?
Oh, here goes.
All right, guys. So we just got here. Went and checked in, got our room, which is dope. You guys saw that. And now we're about to get some food. We decided to get stacks, which is like a pizza, burger.
Build your own burger.
Burger joint. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video because I remember the first time we came here, we were just so amazed at everything that was happening. Guys, we just got blessed to be here for like free through the military. Yeah.
Dinner paid, all things paid for. Like, this
oh
is gonna
my
be
gosh.
Great. Really great.
Right, but this Junior? Is what happens when God blesses you. When you are grateful for everything, everything turns right back around. So I hope you guys enjoy this day and the whole weekend.
We will.
Down the hallway once again.
Roll your boat. Roll your boat.
We'll get there.
Let's go. Roll that boat.
We are officially on our way to the first meeting.
Yes, we are.
They're only going to miss this.
Taking a 5-minute break.
Five?
So Joshua had an episode. We're gonna have to bring his pacifier tomorrow, but I think he's fine right now. He went to sleep.
Oh, so. They told you everything is on?
Yeah, he went to sleep. He's fine right now. we're about to get into the real stuff, you know, so.
You're missing one over here, okay?
Here's an extra folder.
You cried the whole time, buddy? Did you cry the whole time? Oh.
It's
look
okay.
At you.
Oh,
look at
okay.
You.
He was a big boy.
It's all right, buddy.
Yes, okay.
All right, it's day two. And I'm about to go get us some breakfast. It is currently 6:50-ish in the morning. We don't have to be to the place till about 9. I'm just gonna hopefully grab the go boxes and get us some breakfast this morning that we can eat together in peace. This hotel is huge, so y'all wish me luck. I can smell the food. Oh. Doesn't look like that many people out here. I have returned with food. And look who's up. Look, look, look.
Say hi. Good morning. Good morning.
Morning.
You kept mommy up.
That I know. He is not afraid to be inconvenienced or controversial if it means bringing Jesus into the lives and hearts of people. I want to be more like that. I've noticed him being willing to associate with anyone and everyone on the same level, and I want to be more like that. I noticed that he is relentless in his drive to connect with people, and at times that means.
So far, it's been a good morning, thanks to Joshua Sr., because he got us breakfast, since JJ wanted to be a big baby. So, babe's great. He does what he has to do for the family.
Right, so we're gonna practice this technique.
So far we have reviewed what each other's love language is, and it still stands that mine is quality time and Josh's is acts of service.
Yes.
What's your kinda love language?
So mine definitely words of affirmation, then okay. Acts of service are my two big ones.
We're so all, you
know. I love cars, so it's, she helps me working on cars or like helps me wash the car. I'm like really happy. So what about you?
So for me, it's more, you know, when my wife, like when she appreciates me doing housework and stuff, like, you know, because to me, I don't really care if there's some dirt on the floor.
Right.
We have dogs, so it's going to be there again. So when I vacuum and mop the whole house and she appreciates that, that's okay. One of the biggest things for me.
Well,
and what's your name again?
Dylan.
Dylan.
Yeah, okay.
Shout out to Dylan.
Thank you for stopping by.
Yeah, come crash your guys' party.
Yeah, you should do it more often. Maybe somebody else
for me.
Do it too.
This is you.
So here it is. Round two. Our son. It's with us.
Why are you crying?
So, we have one more little session, and we're free. JJ won't be though. He's going back to childcare. I'm such a happy camper over that. Free childcare, bruh. Free hotel, man, look. I'm enjoying this.
So we just got finished with our pretty much last session until Sunday morning. Some good stuff, just updates, pretty much things like that. JJ did well this time. He took a nap and everything. So now we're just getting some lunch and then we're gonna have family time. And then we're gonna drop JJ back off and have quality time, just Josh and I.
Sunday, and we're going to enjoy a half day here and the rest of the day in Nashville.
Guys, we were an hour early.
Thanks to me.
Because Babe is punctual. Okay, he is on time. All right. So we're just about to go get something to eat now.
Yep. Get some good old breakfast.
Midi dial, Buddha.
Yeah, man. You know you got one in your left hand, right? There you go.
Matthew chapter 5, 43-48. You've heard that it was said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your Father in heaven. He causes his sun to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. If you love those who love you, what reward will you get? Are not even the tax collectors doing that? And if you greet only your own people, what are you doing more than others? Do not even pagans do that? Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect.
Amen. All right, so we're gonna check out of the hotel now. Everything's finished. We're done with strong bonds for the day. And now we're gonna enjoy each other and be a family again.
So,
JJ's in childcare, and we're gonna hurry up and get him out once we finish packing. And enjoy the rest of our Sunday. Okay, so we're back home now, and we want to close out this video with a couple takeaways of what we learned at the marriage retreat. So one of the things I took away from the Strong Bonds marriage retreat is that there's an app for that. You have the app called Love Nudge, and that app can be found on the Play Store or the App Store, Android, iPhone, doesn't matter. And on the app, you and your spouse can take the 5 love language quiz and be able to learn what your primary and secondary love languages are, so forth and so on, and be able to get reminders on how to speak your love language and tips on how to speak the other's love language. And I feel that that is important, and I didn't know that.
Yeah. True, what I took away from this weekend was the fact that Gary Chapman, the founder of the 5 Love Languages, he incorporated the fact that everybody starting off only has these feelings And pretty much he says to, instead of going towards each other's feelings, learn about how to speak the other's love language. And so in that, that's how you grow in your marriage. He also included divorce and infidelity and what to do and what not to do if you're in those situations, which are very, very important. So we encourage you guys to, if you're in the military, if you are not in the military, if you're going through a tough time, if you're at the beginning, if you're dating, you know, read the five love languages. It's all about resources and trying to give your spouse the best of you. And I'm pretty sure they would appreciate it if they could speak the same language as you. So.
And with that being said, this concludes our video. Make sure you share this video because there's always somebody that needs to know. So share, like, comment. And if you're not a part of the royal court, please subscribe.
Right now.
Thank you all for watching. We love you all. Have a good day.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Say bye-bye.
Yay!
Yay! Bye-bye.